the members of the Uganda Army and Air Force decided to take over from the civilian role because of the last arrangement which were made by the Dr. Apollo Milton Obote to disarm the all tribe of Uganda except his own tribe Langi and Acholi. And also that is the point which brought all these problems.
How did you feel, sir, when you heard about the coup and
Well, you can guess what it was.
You're obviously very happy.
Yes, I'm very happy. Very, very happy. Yes. I think the whole country is very happy.
Must go to their country.
Even nationals of Uganda.
If they want to go, they are welcome to go.
What will happen to these people if they don't go by the time they leave?
I think they will be sitting like they are sitting on the fire. I will tell you this. You just wait after 3 months.
What will you do to them?
Okay, you will see.
You said you wanted Uganda.
I think they will not sit comfortable here in Uganda. I will tell you this. I must actually tell you the truth.
Have you asked the British to take them away?
So that you are building camping camp for them if they are not doing
it? I am not responsible for building them transit camp.
But have you asked the British to take them away, sir?
Yes, it is the British High Commission is here, his responsibility.
Yes.
I have told him.
You've said you wanted to teach Britain a lesson, President. Why is that?
And that is now lesson I'm teaching the British. I am teaching now the lesson because I am correcting them from the mistake they had made. If they had think before earlier that there is an African here who can even work and building the railway with the instruction given to them by the British, this problem will not happen. What are you giving me? What is more you are giving me? British actually deceived me last year, giving me £10 million, they never give up to now. When I had a really very critical problem of finance up to now. Now I don't want that man again.
I will tell you that United States of America, whether they make economic embargo in Uganda, we will not feel it even an inch. We are very rich and we will not ask any penny from United States, and we wanted to be myself with the people of Uganda, very friendly to the people, to Jimmy Carter and his government of United States. But embargo will not do anything to us because we can buy whatever we want. We have the money, we can buy all over the world. I would like to inform you that whatever you are getting, press, propaganda, news media, either from Kenya or from Tanzania or from Zambia, this is a nonsense report because you are getting from the exile. Exile will never speak good about their government. Every country today in the world, Soviet Union, America, British, Nigeria, Kenya, Tanzania, Zambia, everywhere in the world. They have got their exile. They never speak good about their government.